What is the most worth it item you have ever purchased? A portable phone battery. All the time I waste looking for a charger when I'm out is now time I waste on Reddit. 4-inch memory foam mattress topper. Got my first one for the dorms and have had one since because I am still too broke to invest in a decent bed. Extra phone chargers. Saves so much time and stress knowing I'll have one in my kitchen car and bedroom without having to worry about my phone. And in her natural form. She's either a blue naked Rebecca Romijn or a blue naked Jennifer Lawrence. Which is an absolute win. Nest outdoor cam. Neighbor kids broke a window and blamed my yard maintenance guy. Stupid kids. Electric blanket. I can hardly tolerate the cold and you can make you bed toasty before you get under the covers. The warmth is like a nice hug to lull you to sleep. I have chronic fatigue and bought a Roomba knockoff on sale for $175 and now I can actually have clean floors. It's incredible. It would be like the scrolls you see in cartoons where they take off the binder and the paper hits the ground and rolls a mile down the road. Just bought a weighted blanket. Best sleep I've had in years. I'm so happy to hear that this has helped so many of you. It's the little things. Condoms. Jesus pull out Christ. My first coin ever. Thanks folks. You're all sick. And I like it. Well, after 61,000 miles I finally got rid of my tires, which have been trying to kill me for a couple of months now, and bought new tires this past Saturday. So, yeah. Keep good tires on your vehicles. My sewing machine. It's only a $90 machine from Walmart and I barely used it until the last year or so. Now I've found a hobby I enjoy. I'm teaching myself a skill and have even started making money with it selling some of the things I sew. I'm also teaching my children how to use it and my son has sold a couple of the blankets he made. It's teaching him he needs to have a skill and work to earn money. I've used it to repair countless things. From bra straps to hemming pants and making gifts. Overall, it's paid for itself and then some. I'd love to upgrade in the future but for now this cheapy machine does the job and then some. A gym for my basement. They're expensive and I felt like I shouldn't spend so much on a hobby. But I love it. I've probably put $3,000 into it over the last few years. But I have the disposable income and refuse to let myself feel guilty about it. No more waiting for benches or squat racks at a commercial gym. Or backing out because I just don't feel like leaving the house again after getting home from work. It pays for itself in a few years by not having a $600 a year gym membership. And worst case I could probably sell it for $1,500 to $2,000. A Superman bathrobe with a cape attached. If I'm gonna be forever alone, might as well be Superman. I bought an 8-outlet power strip with surge protectors and 4 USB charger plugins built into the power strip. I have everything on my entertainment stand all plugged in and a phone charger that reaches from there all the way to the couch. Geralt of Rivia would be an incredible, passionate, animalistic lover. He would overpower me, pin me down, and ravish my body until I climaxed. Then he would do it again, and again, until I was utterly exhausted. After what would be hours, he would finish inside me with a grunt, and then caress me as he washed my tender flesh with a warm rag. Then, without a word, he'd dress himself and exit the room, leaving me to dream of him for years afterward. Arthur Morgan would be a slow, gentle, careful lover. He'd run his calloused fingers through my hair, drawing his thumb along my jawbone as he kisses me tenderly, his beard tickling my lips. I'd tremble beneath him, and feeling his fur chest and soft belly against my bare skin would make me moan. He would make sure my pleasure came first, and when I am satisfied, he'll run his hands beneath my back and hold me as he thrusts deep and deliberately inside me. And then right before he climaxes he'll bite his lip but it won't stop his loud gasps and moans. He'd hold me afterward, and I'd fall asleep nestled in his arms, and he'd slip away quietly. But write me a letter a few months afterward to let me know he thinks of me when he sees bluebonnets and daisies. Oh, for sure the bark loungers. Me and my roommate just love them. Perfect to just sit then and watch Baywatch with some beers and pizza. This one is for Jennifer Lawrence, any character ever played by Anna Kendrick. Arm implant hormonal birth control. I have no periods. I have no cramps related to menstruation. I have zero worries about blood staining my clothes by surprise or running out of supplies. I only keep tampons for visitors now. And I don't track cycles at all. Don't count days to estimate if I should wear pale pants or not. Or whether I should bring a bathing suit on a trip. Don't even worry about it. Holy duck, it's freeing. My education. Like most people, my parents didn't have money in a bank account somewhere for my college, so I did the loan thing and any scholarships that I could. Got an engineering degree and was able to, eventually, work my way into a career I truly enjoy that also allows me to live happily and comfortably. I still pay student loans actually, so I guess technically I haven't finished he purchased, but I know without my education I wouldn't have the life I have now. When I spent 800 yen for an hour in a Japanese cat cafe, around $7.15. It was a cute little studio apartment but furnished with copious cat condos and cute cat memorabilia. Also, at least half of the cats had cute little handmade collars on them. My daughter. 13 grand for IVF was worth every penny. She'll be one next month, and this past year with her has been incredible. Muscled and straightforward, although a bit too much I guess. I would give a lot to get ducked by him, and I think my type is definitely shaped by his looks a lot lol. A towel warmer. Not the kind with the bars that you drape a towel over. The towel spa you put your towel in before and while you shower, so when you get out of the shower you have a piping hot water towel to wrap around you. Even the hubs uses it regularly and loves it. I also use it to warm my robe at night on cold evenings to wear while watching television before turning in. Warmy goodness. Life insurance at an early age. I have crazy cheap life insurance because I got most of it when I was in my early 20s, and now that I have a family to provide for in case something happens, I don't have to worry about it. A London Fog trench coat from a thrift store for $15. It is to this day my favorite piece of clothing. Fits me perfectly too. Voyager. Resistance is erotically futile. A portable dishwasher. My fiancé and I live in an apartment without a dishwasher or a place to hook one up. It was fine for a while. But then we were both working full-time. With him doing additional side work on top of his full-time job and me working swing shift rotating between days and nights and going to school. Our house was a wreck. We'd come home and were so exhausted. Then on our days off spend hours doing the dishes. I love to cook and bake and just stop because it became too much work and our extremely busy schedules made it hard to keep up. Finally I said duck it. We're buying a portable dishwasher. Best purchase ever. This will probably not get seen. And it is a bit NSFW, but for anyone who suffers from pruritus on E, itchy butt, I got a cream about 5 years ago that you can apply to protect and stop the itch. Before this I was nearly suicidal from lack of sleep. It is just a terrible feeling to be itchy all night. After using the cream it is way more manageable. It isn't a cure. But it stops the symptoms so well. Best $50 I ever spent. One time my friend and I were sleeping outside Walmart for a week waiting for the WII to release, and this guy wheels out a cart full of potatoes. Like, only potatoes. So many potatoes. And my friend goes, potatoes? And the guy just goes, potatoes are so worth it. And we both died. Ever since then, whenever something is so worth it, we say it's potatoes. Helix foam bed. Same thing as Casper or Purple. It's honestly changed my life. A Ducati Multistrada. Depends on your interests, but I'll never regret that purchase. A Leatherman multi-tool. The most handy tool in the world. My Brita jug. Use it every day multiple times a day. The biggest advantage for me is not that the water is cleaner, but that it's colder because I can keep it in the fridge. Tap water is never cold enough. Leia. Leia's mom. Mary Jane Watson. Miss Sandy. Wonder Woman. Cassandra from Wayne's World. Definitely my Fitbit. My mom would always say, "You're in college, you walk constantly, just eat what you want," and I didn't understand why I was putting on weight. Turns out I was walking about 2,000 steps daily while on a college diet. Totally changed my perspective on how active I really was. A pretty nice pair of headphones, not audiophile ones though. I love music and it's so great. Plus he can shapeshift or change size, so it would be ultimate win for me. On Black Friday I got a Chromebook for $50. Even though I have a laptop, I bought one anyway. Now I don't even use my laptop and take my Chromebook everywhere. Asterisk. A garlic press. $10. Before, I had to peel and mince garlic. Get my fingers all sticky. Now the garlic press does it in 3 seconds. It even simultaneously peels it. 10 tenths, it's basically black magic. A meal canister vacuum. I had read the forums from the vacuum repair tech and he recommended Meal over all the other ones. My girlfriend and I found the C3 Total Care on sale in Canada for $650 and I jumped on it. She was hesitant to spend that much on a vacuum, but it outperforms the $200 uprights by leaps and bounds. So much quieter. Can get into tight spaces. Better suction. A power head for the carpets. And from what I have heard, will last upwards of 30 years if the proper upkeep is done. Spending a little more to get a premium product is sometimes worth it, and this is definitely one of those cases. Rachel from Friends. Also Joanna from Office Space. Maybe Polly from Along Came Polly. Or really any character Jennifer Aniston is playing. Princess Peach. It's been a thing since I was 10 years old. Edit. There are people in this thread listing underage girls to overwhelming support. And somehow I'm getting buried for a childhood crush on Princess Peach. Never change. Reddit. Has no one said Mary Poppins? Genie from Bewitched. Come on now, don't forget the classics.